Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Please take a seat. Shubham.
Thank you, sir.
Shubham is from Bikaner.
Yes, sir.
And studied in Kota, studied in IIT Kanpur.
Yes,
sir. Now doing M.Tech.
Yes, sir.
Great. Let's start with your home state. Are you comfortable with Rajasthan?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You have a doubt?
Basic knowledge about Rajasthan.
Okay. Basic things. Tell me, which are the main industries in Rajasthan and where are they located in Rajasthan?
So, Kota Stone Factory is there in Rajasthan, which is in Kota. The moat production in
the
moat dal. It is one kind of dal.
Okay, industry.
Moat processing industries.
Okay.
In Bikaner,
in the processing of dal.
Yes, sir.
Fine.
Also, there are marble factories in Makrana, Degana.
Good.
So, and these are
anything you can think of which is produced in Rajasthan and exported from India.
Yes, sir. Guar gum is exported from Rajasthan.
Guar?
Guar gum, which is used for thickening of water for
something more valuable than that in terms of money, revenue generated.
Sir, marble is one of the...
Marble is one, yes. Which part of Rajasthan you get marble in?
Makrana, Degana.
Where is Makrana?
It is near Mehta Road, which is almost the center of the Rajasthan.
Okay. I am going to Rajasthan and I want to see birds. Where will you take me?
Sir,
I'm interested in bird watching.
So I don't remember.
No place, never heard of a bird sanctuary in Rajasthan.
I have heard, but
yes.
I'm not able to remember the name.
Where?
Sarishka Park is there. Once.
Sarishka is known for tiger.
It's tigers.
Never been to Bharatpur?
No, sir.
Okay, doesn't matter. You are a cricket player, you are a chess player, you have mathematics quiz. What is Ramanujan number?
It is...
It's one of the easier questions,
yes,
for mathematics.
1727.
No, 1727, sure.
1728, I guess.
No, so many guesses are not allowed.
Sorry, sir.
For a champion. Then next you will say 1729, which happens to be correct. Have you heard of something called Ramanujan Square?
No, sir, I don't remember.
Nothing to do with the numbers, different. No idea?
No,
okay, then you're a cricket player, chess player.
Yes,
I'll ask you questions from one of the two sports, cricket or chess. You choose, then I'll ask you a question. Maybe a difficult one then.
Cricket?
Yes. Oh. And today something is starting.
Yes, sir.
What?
It is India versus England.
England test
match.
They say it is a ping ball test.
Yes,
and everybody is talking about the problems of ping ball test. What makes ping ball different from the usual red ball? And why people are apprehensive?
Yes, sir. So, the usual red ball we can't use in day-night test matches. The reason being...
Forget about that. That's why we are using pink.
Yes, sir.
How is pink ball different from that from the point of a cricket player?
Yes, sir. So, when we play at night, the red ball, if we play with red ball, the pitch color and the ball color...
Again, I'm not asking that why we are using pink ball. No. What is the difference between the pink ball and the red ball? Why is the discussion that pink ball Indians may find difficult? Or some other, and in fact, India has been reluctant to play normally with ping ball. Why?
Okay.
No idea. You know what is a no ball?
Yes, sir.
Give me three examples.
The first is when the player leg it crosses the crease.
It crosses the crease. I'm sorry, it's not correct. Next, this answer is not correct. Next.
The second is when the ball is above the waist, which is direct ball, above the waistline.
Okay.
And thirdly, when the ball, when it is,
I come back to the first one, last question. Why did I say your first answer is not correct? You said when the leg or the foot crosses the line.
Yes, sir.
Why did I say, think of it again, it's not correct?
The foot completely crosses the line.
Oh, even if it is on the line, it is a no ball. A part of it should be behind the line actually. Sir.
Shubham, you are an aerospace engineer.
Yes, sir.
Then how did you got transferred to data sciences?
Sir, it is interdisciplinary course. For me, I am more to the mechanical and aerospace side. For example, I am taking finite element methods and I am doing that side.
You have done so, finite element methods and yes, what else? What is the latest in finite element method?
Sir, I am actually started this semester.
Just started. Okay. Now tell me, we use boundary layer theory a lot in aerospace.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me something about its origin and applications?
So the boundary layer is basically the nearest region near the airfoil shape.
No, I said origin.
I'm sorry, I don't remember.
When did it start? Who started it?
So I don't know.
No. Okay, application part of it?
It is the nearest region on the plate or airfoil shape. Which describes the screen friction drag which the body will inculcate, and also the where the flow is laminar, where the flow is turbulent. These all
that even without boundary layer you can find out whether flow is laminar or turbulent without going into the consideration of boundary layer. You can decide whether flow is laminar or turbulent.
So inside the boundary layer region, there are pressure gradients, the velocities gradients.
Velocity gradient. Pressure gradient may not be there.
Pressure gradient.
If fluid is flowing uniformly, there may not be any pressure gradient.
Okay. So we generally use to calculate this drag which the body will
correct.
Have.
Okay. Supposing you have to calculate drag on your aircraft profile, or you can say wing. What is the method of doing it?
One method is the wind tunnel testing, in which we will attach the airfoil or the aircraft which we are making on the on a stick, and then we will flow the air around it, and then we will calculate how much the force it is on the rod, so that the it is equal to the drag at that point.
Supposing I don't have an air tunnel, wind tunnel. It is called wind tunnel when you do this testing.
Yes.
But still I want to test this wing. But I have a water tunnel.
Okay.
I don't have a wind tunnel, but I have a water tunnel in my facilities.
Yes.
Will I be able to do the experimentation as you said in air tunnel? Can I do the experimentation in water tunnel and then find out drag?
Yes sir, we can do there. We can use the non-dimensional number for comparing
what
like Reynolds number?
What is that number?
Reynolds number is one of the number. Also, we can use Mach number of the flow.
In water tunnel, you will not get Mach number.
Sorry, sir. Sorry, sir.
Reynolds number similarity you have to maintain.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now the question is, Reynolds number is based upon several properties. Supposing the fluid changes from air to water, can you still have the same Reynolds number?
Yes sir, we can have the same Reynolds number. For example, in the air, the velocity is higher, we will take the low velocities in water. So, but the viscosities and the dimension also we can change in the water and in the air. And the viscosity will remain same, which is the properties of the air and water.
But viscosity and density, you have no control on it.
Yes.
Once you say this fluid is there, then viscosity and density are fixed.
Yes. But
so what remains with you is?
The velocity and the
only
dimension.
Velocity. You have to control the velocity, then only you can get similar or same Reynolds numbers. Okay. Now tell me, you must have done a lot about lift and drag and all these in aerospace.
Yes, sir.
How is lift associated with circulation? You know what is circulation?
Yes, sir.
What is it?
So when the flow passed the airfoil, so the circulation, that is the turning of the fluid, this happens across the airfoil. And when the circulation, that is the velocity of the air, it is downward. So from Newton's third law, the action and reaction are equal and the net lift is generated there.
How is it associated with lift? If I want to calculate lift, and I know the circle, or I can calculate, or I know the circulation. Okay. How is it?
Suppose it is on the cylinder.
What is the formulation, or how will you say calculate lift from circulation?
So the equation is, the lift is equal to integral of rho, the ambient velocities, and the
which
circulation.
Which velocity?
The free stream velocity.
Acha. And?
And the circulation term.
Circulation. Okay. Now, there are certain analogies which we use. Have you heard about analogies? Or what is an analogy? Literal meaning.
When we are comparing one property, one physical criteria with other.
Mm.
So we are making some analogous things, and then
analogy. Okay. Yes. You must have heard some analogies. Colburn analogy.
Yes, sir.
Pantel analogy, and so many others.
Yes, sir.
Where do we use them?
The Colburn analogy we use in the heat transfer, where we can get the heat transfer coefficient, the convective heat transfer coefficient, and the skin friction drag at any local position of the body which we are undertaking. So this is one analogy.
No, but what is the real advantage of this?
In this, we can we don't have the fluid passing through that particular body, we can still, from the skin friction drag, we can calculate the convective heat transfer coefficient, and we can design.
So that is the application, you know.
Yes.
Without going into the details, you can get the results.
Yes.
Okay. Now, have you studied heat transfer also?
Yes, sir.
Have you or not?
Yes, sir.
You have studied. Tell me about different colors which we see. Yellow, orange, green, etc. How do we distinguish these colors?
The main criteria is the wavelength of the these colors.
Wavelength, okay.
So lower is the wavelength, so it is on the violet and indigo side, and the higher wavelength gives red color, orange, yellow.
Any idea about the wavelengths?
Yes, sir. So the range of the wavelength of the visible region is around 0.3 micrometers, 0.3 nanometers to 0.7 nanometers.
Nano?
I'm sorry, I'm confusing it.
You were correct earlier.
Micrometers. Sorry, sir.
Not nano. Microns.
Microns. Yes. Yes, sir.
Oh, say it again.
So it is 0.3 to 0.7 nanometers, micrometers.
Approximately, okay.
300 to 700.
Kid nanometers, you are saying?
300 to 700 nanometers.
Either say it like that, otherwise best is to say in microns.
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 Rather than saying in nanometers.
Okay,
right? Supposing you are using this microwave. You have a microwave in your kitchen? Microwave oven?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is the wavelength or frequency we use in that?
The wavelength of the microwave will be...
Wavelength or frequency, whatever you want.
It will be higher. It will be around 300 to 500 micrometers, which is after the infrared region.
300 to?
500.
Approximately. 500.
Achha. Of that order.
Hmm.
So these are the microwaves which we use.
Radio waves, you mean?
Microwaves.
Microwaves are also the microwaves.
Okay, huh? The region which is.
You know, radio waves. What are these?
So the waves which are used for communications, they are called radio waves.
Only for communication.
There are many applications.
Also,
I don't remember all exactly.
X-rays, you know.
Yes, sir.
They fall under what category?
They have the low wavelength and high frequency, and they are generally used for X-rays of bodies, and also in the fission reactions, the X-rays are generated.
X-rays in fission.
X-rays.
See, if you go for X-ray examination,
okay,
You might have gone or not, I don't know. If you go to the hospital.
You can shift it.
Okay, can you please tell me what is laminar sublayer? So it is the layer of the fluid which is very close to the plate in the turbulent region, where the velocity profile is linear.
It is linear or treated linear?
It is treated linear in laminar. Because the flow is laminar and the shear stress, it is assumed to be constant.
In turbulent region, the flow is laminar?
Very close to the boundary.
Why? Okay. Suppose there is a turbulent flow over a flat plate. I think these things were there in your syllabus, no?
Yes, sir.
So that is the thing which I'm asking. Turbulent flow over the flat plate, what is the shape of velocity profile?
It is a logarithmic shape. In the pipe flow, it is a logarithmic. In the turbulent region in the flat plate, the profile is of the order y by delta to the power 1 by 7. The power
1/7 power law.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Passenger plane and fighter plane, is there be any difference in the airfoil section?
Yes, sir.
आपसे बहुत पूछा जाएगा because your branch is aerospace and that is from IIT Kanpur.
Yes,
IIT Kanpur department is also very good in aerospace. तो आपसे fluid mechanics, solid mechanics बहुत पूछा जाएगा.
In the passenger aircraft, I will say the airfoil use is of a square shape or rectangular shape, but in the fighter aircraft we generally go for delta wings, which gives a higher velocity, higher Mach number. This is one of the difference.
Okay, how lift is created from airfoil section? Can you draw and tell me?
Yes, sir. So this is a general airfoil shape. So when the air flows, so the upper region is somewhat compressing the fluid. So here the velocity increases, and in this region,
यही मैं आपसे पूछ रहा हूँ जो आपने बोला ना ऊपर, the flow is compressed. So, can you show in this diagram how the flow is compressed?
Yes, sir. If I zoom it, then the foil is something like that. And if the air is flowing like this.
Yes.
Now, this air is, this much region is going into the smaller region.
But after that?
After that, it will expand.
Okay. Then what will happen?
So, in the rear region of the airfoil, wakes are created.
Okay.
So, but the lift is generally generated in the front portion of the airfoil.
Any point in this airfoil where the flow gets separated?
Yes, sir.
Boundary layer separation?
Yes, sir. It occurs.
It occurs?
It occurs when the angle of attack is more.
Okay. Last question. What is the main difference? Just one line answer, right? Ek line mein answer karne ki koshish kariye. What is the main difference between the conduction and convection?
The motion due to vibration. The heat transfer due to vibration is conduction, but the bulk flow, it is the heat transfer due to molecular vibration is conduction, and adding the advection effect, which is the bulk phenomena, it gives the convection effect.
Okay, sir.
Okay. What is your first choice in services?
Central Power Engineering Service.
Okay, tell me the what is the present energy scenario in India?
Presently, 63% are of thermal power sources.
Within thermal, what is the contribution of coal, oil, gas?
I don't know exactly.
Okay, other than 63%?
Other than 63, 24 approximately is the renewable sector, where the solar energy, wind energy are there. And very few, 2 to 3% is nuclear energy.
Okay. Last year there was accident took place in NTPC Uchahar steam power plant. What was the reason behind it?
Some water.
Okay. What is the main function of soot blowers in the power plants, steam power plants?
Sorry, I don't know exact reason.
Okay. What is the function of cooling tower?
Cooling tower is we use to cool the outgoing air to the ambient, to close to ambient temperature.
What are the different types of cooling towers?
Sir, one is when we spray some water also.
Name?
Open type.
Okay, out of ID and FD, ID cooling tower and FD cooling towers, Which one is preferable and why?
The induced one is preferred more because it will give the more developed flow in the cooling tower section.
Okay. Why the shape of the cooling tower is of hyperbolic type? Actually, you have filled Central Power Engineering Services as your first choice. That's why I'm asking.
There is something to not aware actually. Maybe the size, I can guess.
You can guess.
No, so the shape of the fin should ideally should be hyperbolic in nature, so that's so that the more heat transfer can occur. That can be one of the reasons.
Okay. Anything else?
No, sir.
Take him. Do you know something about cryogenic engines?
Yes, sir.
Tell me.
So in this the fuel air mixture, they are fuel and air, the oxygen, and they are kept at very low temperature.
Limits, values?
This will be minus, it will be 50 Kelvin approximately.
So what are the presently working fluids which are available at such a low temperatures, which can work under these situations?
The liquid hydrogen, liquid oxygen, these are the two fuels which we use in cryogenics.
Okay. What is the meaning of Cottrell atmosphere?
So, in material science, when we go from the yield point, after the yield point, the atmosphere, Cottrell atmosphere start to begin. In this, the defects like,
Okay, my last question. What is the meaning of purging in power plant, related to power plant, and why we are doing? Purging, P-U-R-G-I. Yes. You heard this?
Sorry, sir.
Interview is over. This is just to help you. A little feedback to improve you. You have a pleasant personality. Your smile is good. Your eye contact is good. All that is good. Interview part. But you need to have more substance in your answers. Knowledge. Yes. Your qualifications. And if somebody looks at your experience and qualifications, your expectations from you will be higher. Of course, my friends will tell you about the technical. I'm only telling you two things. When you fill up this form, NAF, normally interview will start with the chairperson as it happens here. So first 5-6 minutes are very important because that gives you confidence or breaks your confidence. The rest of the interview can depend on that. And invariably, the chairperson asks you from three things. Not beyond that. One, current affairs, what's happening in the world. Two, your DAF. And three, what you basically have been doing all your life, say home state, I ask. So these three things, can you prepare or not? When I ask home state about Rajasthan industries, you are very, very shaky. There's so many other things. There's so much of auto industry today between Delhi and Jaipur, Alwar, etc. That automobile industry, so many things. Copper is there, zinc is there, isn't it? So go on to that. Go on that. Similarly, when you opted for cricket, they are going to try to correlate just as I did. What is happening today and what is your hobby? So I asked you about the pink test, ball test. Go and read it now.
Yes.
There's something. The pink ball is expected to swing more and spin less. Both the things Indians do not like. That's the reason. Okay. So, do these three things. So, I will tell you more about it.
Shubham, since you have studied at IIT Kanpur and now you are pursuing your M.Tech also at Indian Institute of Science, so you should be at a higher pedestal. So, you see, though the questions asked may be simple, but your answers should be to the point. Especially aerospace engineering, and if you say you don't know about the region of boundary layer, have you not read Schlichting's boundary layer theory or Prandtl's?
Yes, sir. Prandtl boundary
layer. It is bilkul basic. Ekdam basic it is there for aerospace engineering. So, ye sab thoda padh lijiye. Aur isi tarah se application part of it also you should revise. Okay, just keep this in mind, otherwise you can do very well. What hard work is required, whatever time is left for. When is your interview, by the way?
15th March. 15th.
So still you have time.
Still you have time. Such an opportunity doesn't come every day. Work hard. Okay?
And same thing, because you have filled your central power engineering services, so definitely they will ask question from power scenario. Okay, so prepare at least basic of power plant and present energy scenario if anything happened before your interview, especially. Okay.
And mechanics and solid mechanics, both are very important for you. Origin of boundary layer. A big Prandtl 1904.
Boundary layer is the most important thing for you. Okay. Keep in mind.
Right.
Okay, thank you. Okay. All the best.